Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we'll be doing an unboxing and review of this, the Sega Saturn Wireless Controller from Retrobit. Let me get this open and start up here. Okay. Yeah. There we go. Yes, it's dark. And we got another box. Wow! That's pretty cool, actually. Look at that. Dang. Nice. You really went all out on this one. Okay, let's see. How do you open this thing? Push here and pull up. Yep, there you go. And there it is, guys. Now this is awesome. Kind of... Oh wow. Okay. Hold on. Wrong hand. There we go. Let's see. Shoryuken, Hadouken, spinning power driver. Let's see. Got a start button here. Hold on. Plastic. There we go. Ah, beautiful. Okay, what do we have here? Home button. A select button. Okay. Yeah, feels pretty good. Okay, what type of... Oh, it's just a USB... Ah, USB mini port. Yeah. Okay. So, let's see. Is there a... I don't see an on and off button. Okay, I'm going to charge this bad boy up. So that's that. On here, you have a Saturn port. Sorry about that. This is for the Saturn. Nice, actually. A little Retrobit logo there. Very nice. I guess he has the pair button. Pair the controller with the pad. Okay, there's that one. And... Oh, come on. Fine, go the other way. USB. This is for a PC, for emulators, or... Street Fighter 5, maybe? I don't know. We'll find out. Because we're going to be testing that too. Again, another pair button here. Very nice, actually. Okay, so that's all that's in the box. Yep. Okay, anything under here? I'm guessing the manual and so on, but... Yeah, there we are. There's a charging cable. Alright. Yep, got a charging cable. USB B? BB. Or mini, I'm sorry, mini. Micro mini. Whatever. Thank you for your purchase. We know you enjoy your Retrobit product as much as we enjoy gaming. And that. Okay. So there's that. We have our manual here. Yeah. You know, I think I could pretty much figure this out. Alright, guys, I'm going to charge this bad boy up. And I'll get back to you when we'll get back with a test. Oh, one other thing. What I want to do today is something a little different. And I kind of held this on the side for a while now. But we're going to be using this instead of the Saturn. Oh, yeah. We're going to test that on the Dreamcast. Because if it works for a Saturn, it should work for the Dreamcast. Hypothetically, of course. We shall see. Okay, are you back? Alright guys, I was looking at the manual, and yeah, I cheated. Anyway, it's interesting because it shows the button layout here for the controller. And then you get the button layout for other consoles like PC, PS3, Genesis Mini, and so on. I found it kind of interesting. It says it works with the PlayStation 3 as well on the Switch, Android. I don't see how that's possible, but okay. So yeah, pretty cool. They actually give you the a cheat sheet for it. Alright guys, well my controller is still charging, so we'll be back in a couple minutes. But yeah, dog, just show you that real quick. Okay, one sec. Alright guys, I'm back. Sorry about my roommate's TV. These old people, they got their TVs all blasting loud. So I got my controller, it's charged up. I'm gonna try the PC first because my PC's on right now, so why not? Okay, stick it to the USB port here. And okay, that's on. Here we go. Windows detected it. Okay, now just hit start. Okay, it's waiting to sync. Push the button. There we go. It's solid. We're hooked. Alright. Let's fire up Steam and play some Street Fighter. Okay, guys. So, I went to Control Panel. You go to Devices and Printers. And let's see. Which one is it here? Logitech. I think this one's it. That's maybe doing it left there. Let's see. Properties, no. Okay, how do I do this? No, that's not, that's my receiver, okay. Is it down here? Okay, that's right there actually. Yeah. Is it? Uh-oh. Something happened. That can't be good. When plug and play isn't plug and play. It's my plug and or play. Alright, I'll get back. Alright, okay, so I think I found the problem. Problem was my Xbox 360 wireless on receiver was causing a little issue with it. So I had to unplug the receiver, so I'm gonna do this here. Settings, properties, and there it is. Okay, so up. Down, left, right. Okay, there they are. They're all working. LNR triggers. And 7, okay. A, B, C. That's odd. X, Y, and Z. Okay. So it's all those. There's no home button there. And select button. Oh. Yep. Alright. Alright, guys. I'm gonna put you down here real quick. I'm gonna watch. Hopefully, you guys can see okay, because I really can't see that. But anyway. Alright, so. As you can see, it's working pretty well, actually. I'm gonna go into arcade. A doesn't work. Okay. Well, it works. B. Why is B A? It makes no sense. Yeah, whatever. Street Fighter 1. Yeah, why not?
Street Fighter 1.
Okay. My man, Ken.
Hey, I was waiting for you.
Really? Gonna play Birdie. Cheat, cheat, cheat. And here we go. See if my buttons are correct by default. If not, I'll have to change everything. Typical. Okay. No, that's not jab. That's jab. That's roundhouse. And short, fierce, and medium. Kick. Okay. And starts not starting. What is going on here? You know, it works for PC, but yeah, starts not starting and pausing. Alright guys, but it works, I mean, but yeah, anyway. So PC's got issues.